In the following video, I'll explain the process principle of polymer powder bed fusion. This video is the start to the powder bed fusion processes, and here you see a couple of examples that you've seen partly already. We have the polymer powder bed fusion parts, we have here some metal powder bed fusion parts, and some newer technologies that we also talk about at the end of this video series. So first off, you might remember that powder bed fusion is defined as a process in which thermal energy selectively fuses regions of a powder bed. So we have a powder bed compared to vat photopolymerization, where we had a vat of liquid resin and we fuse regions together by melting in the vat photopolymerization process, for example, that was a light activated curing process. So here we have melting and we have a powder bed instead of a liquid vat. So I'm pointing this out just that you get familiar with these processes and the differences. So again, we'll talk about some common names and trade names. In powder bed fusion processes, that's the most important thing to distinguish because there are a couple of traps hidden here. First, you can see that there's differences between polymer and metals. So powder bed fusion is a process that comprises both polymer powders and metal powders. So LS or laser sintering is used for polymers. SLS, selective laser sintering, probably the most common term when powder bed fusion isn't used. And then multi-jet fusion, MJF, which is a newer process and doesn't work with a laser heat source. We talk about that at the very end. But all three are different abbreviations for polymer powder bed fusion processes. Then we have the metal group. Here we have LM for laser melting, SLM for a selective laser melting, DMLS for direct metal laser sintering, which are all three with lasers, and EBM is electron beam melting. So that's also powder bed fusion process, also uses powder, but the energy source, the heat source, is an electron beam instead of a laser. So instead of interacting with the photons, or based on the photons, it's the electrons that are being excited. And there's others, but another thing I want to point out as I'm talking about the names is you see, especially for polymers, it's always referred to a sintering process, but it's very important to remember and internalize that powder bed fusion processes are all based on melting and solidification, not sintering. Sintering might happen as a byproduct, nothing that we particularly want. We want melting and solidification. Sintering is reserved for other processes that we talk about in other videos. To understand the process, we'll look at the schematic of it. And some things will now become more and more familiar as you look at more and more of these processes and schematics. So what we see here on the right is a build platform that's moving down. It contains the powder and these are two fully built parts and a partially built bigger part. We see the laser and scanning mirror, which we have seen in other processes. And now on the left, we see a powder supply that is in a cartridge that moves up and supplies new powder. And we also have a leveling roller, which could also be a blade. So what's happening in this process is, as we're done with one layer, the build platform moves down and makes room for more powder. This powder is provided by the powder supply or powder reservoir. As this is moving up, some excess powder is sitting on top of the edge here, and the leveling roller is sweeping by and depositing this excess powder on the build platform or the powder bed. And now the laser is coming in and selectively fusing the areas that are supposed to be melted for the next layer. When that is finished, the build platform is moving down, the powder supply is moving up, providing more powder. The leveling roller is taking up the powder from the powder supply and depositing on the powder bed. So this process can continue and continue. We'll look at a video, again from Solids Concept, so it's already a little bit older, and I'll walk you through what we see and what's happening here. So this is an example of a machine. The window, the control, and down here the powder bed. So what you see here when it starts to shine, that means the laser has just hit the material and tracing that outline, and it becomes a little bit more shiny as it's melting. You see a couple of very delicate parts that have inner channels, very high freedom of degrees of freedom for the part design. This is a drone, flying drone. And now we see the pre-processing. We do the slicing and create STL files of the individual layers. We see the laser tracing. Oh, the blue was just the laser right now. We see the powder being coated. In this case, it comes from left to right, so we have powder supplies on both sides. And you see it gets shiny, so it's melted, new powder is applied, we don't even see it, and we see it again. So the laser tracing one layer. And now in the next view, here we see it from the front, and I'm going to stop it for a second. So what you see here is we have the part build chamber in the middle, and the powder cartridge, one on the right and one on the left. The right one is the active one right now, so in order to create the next layer, the powder cartridge on the right will move the powder supply up, and the roller who's currently positioned on the right will sweep over, deposit the powder on the part build chamber, and move all the way to the left, and then as we need the next layer, the powder cartridge on the left is moving up and supplying the material. So we get, the roller doesn't have to move back in between, we get powder from both sides being deposited. So we move on in the video, and we see we have two layers here, now the yellow, and we get another layer in blue. Now the powder is moved down, now the cooling process starts, talk about that in a second. Now we see an animation of how the powder is taken out, or the parts are taken out. So the powder bed is pushed up. We take the whole powder out, and now we start to remove the loose powder from the solidified parts. It's a very dusty process. You do that by hand, and then you use sandblasting and other blasting technologies to get rid of all of it. Here's just another little show of how the tracing of the layer looks with the laser and how it becomes shiny. Here you see some parts, complex parts, ducts, motorcycle, that indicates that you can make a lot of structural parts. And that last example also showed it, that you can do cool archaeological or art artifacts.